What's up, y'all? We are back again with some iOS 14 tips and tricks that I'm sure you guys aren't aware of, and I'm here to spill all the tea, okay? We're talking functionality and aesthetic. Okay, so iOS 14 has been out for a while now, and pretty much everybody knows the basics. You can customize your apps, you can add widgets to your screen, but today I'm gonna give you 5 tips to better enhance your aesthetics for your screen, as well as functionality. My last video, link it up here, but my last video, I pretty much talked about how aesthetic over functionality was key, but now I figured out some tips to better enhance your iOS 14 experience, and I'm gonna list all 5. If you stick to the end, I have one bonus tip that I'd like to give you guys, and it's personally one of my favorites, something that I'm hoping Apple will actually implement themselves, but there's a little bit of workaround for it. Okay, so I'm gonna pull up my screen, and if you watch my last video, you'll notice that it is drastically different than the first video that I posted. It's a lot more dark and moody. I don't know if it's moody, but it's definitely darker than my first, the first time I edited my screen. Like most YouTubers around here who've posted a second video, their screens are pretty different than they were the first time. So here's my screen. It's pretty much like a coffee aesthetic. I'm not like a coffee connoisseur, okay? But I love some coffee, and I think it looks good in pictures, so why not? Okay, so my first tip is definitely the extreme lag between opening up an app and having to deviate to shortcuts first. So there's a way to reduce this and to speed it up just a little bit and make it a little bit more bearable to kind of watch, and that's by reducing motion. If I were to open up an app right now, you'll see the shortcuts app first, and it'll kind of do like a little swoop-de-doo over to the other app, but I'm gonna show you how to speed that up. So what you're gonna do first is you're gonna go to your settings, you're gonna type motion, and then you'll see reduce motion. You wanna select that, check that on, and then close your screen. And I'll show you a big difference, okay? So now when you go to open up your app, it's gonna look a lot smoother, and even if you look away from your phone for a split second, you might not even notice it. Definitely a lot smoother, and like I said, if you look away from your screen, you don't even notice that it's opening shortcuts. So I really, really like that tip. The next tip that I have is widget stacks. And of course we know that Apple already comes customized with widget stacks, but you can stack your own widgets as well. So it's kind of like a hidden treasure box. So one of the widget stacks that I have, I bet you couldn't even point them out, but the one widget stack that I do have is my widget stack with color widgets at the top that has my clock and date. So if I swipe down on that, you'll see that I also have Google search as well as access to maps right away. That way I don't have to open up the Google app or open up the Maps app. It's all hidden away. And then when I want the aesthetic back on the screen, I'll just swipe back down. You just wanna hold on the home button, press the add. You'll find a widget. Let's say weather, for example. Add widget. And you're just going to drag that widget on top and drop it in. It's like you've never seen it. I also have another widget stack over here that shows how many steps I did. Don't judge me, okay? I didn't walk around that much. If I swipe down, it also shows me the weather here, and it also shows me a picture of me and my boyfriend. That's the album that I showed in my previous video. Just to keep everything seamless and everything black on the right side of the screen, I've hid that within a widget stack. Tip number 3, you might notice that none of my apps actually have any words written under it. So I've literally gotten rid of all of the words under the apps just to have the cleanest look possible. Especially on this screen, everything on the right looks super clean, and I love it that way. So pro tip, when you are customizing your shortcuts app, what you want to do is go to your shortcuts, hit the app, hit the 3 dots, hit add to home screen. Instead of leaving the word there, you can delete it completely, and that will add the app to your home screen without any words below it. Or you can either go to thefonts.com or Instagram fonts and type in the word that you actually want, and then pick a font from there, copy and paste it, and add it directly to the shortcut's name. In my last video, I talked about 2 of the apps that I was using. That was Color Widgets and Widget Smith. I found 2 more apps that I absolutely love that I've been able to use to customize my screen to my liking. First of all, a lot of apps haven't fully released their widgets, so there's a lot of workarounds that you have to do. This app called TuneTrack will allow you to link your Spotify account, under music services. But the one thing that I like about ToonTrack is that it's customizable. So ToonTrack allows you to customize the app, the music player that shows on your screen. You can customize the color of the words. The only thing you're not able to customize is the logo for Spotify, which bumps me out, I'm not gonna lie. It bumps me out a lot because I don't like the color green. It is a good widget for me to use in order to access my music and see what's playing right away, maybe change the song. My next favorite widget that I've downloaded is Yidget, okay? If you wanna customize your screen and you wanna have the ability to add blank space to your screen, this is the app. But Yidget allows you to copy pretty much your wallpaper and place widgets exactly in the space of where your wallpaper is. So if you look at the left side of my screen, it's pretty much just the wallpaper. And the same thing for this page, the second page as well, it's just pretty much the wallpaper. The only thing that's a little bit of a bummer is the word Yidget that shows up three times. And pretty much it'll put squares or Yidgets around the parts of the screen where widget would normally fall. So you can do small, you can do medium, and you can do large. I have three widgets on the left side that just kind of pop into place, and you would literally have no idea, unless you've seen the word Yidget, that they're there. The next tip that I have is obviously the wallpaper that I have downloaded in order to have that blank space, or it looks like a split screen on my iPhone. If you open up Canva and do, let's say, poster or flyer, you can choose a blank one, and then you can also add your photo. So if you've added an image, let's say for example, I'm gonna add me throwing a pumpkin, I'm going to resize it, and I'm actually going to center it. It gives you these little lines and options to show you when it's hit the center of the screen and when it's level horizontally and vertically. And then the right side of the screen, you can pretty much either add another picture or you can just leave it blank or add a separate color. Okay, and to wrap things up, I have one more thing that I absolutely love. I'm gonna link below exactly how to do this because as of now, it's not the smoothest method, okay? Pretty much it's picture in picture, which everyone knows iOS 14 has, but unfortunately, YouTube doesn't support it. If you open up the YouTube app and you click on a video, there's an option to do picture in picture and get around YouTube not having the ability to do picture in picture. All you have to do is hit the share button, scroll over to more, and then hit this YouTube picture in picture icon. That'll run a script through shortcuts and allow me to have a picture in picture for the YouTube app. Literally a lifesaver. But I will link below exactly what I did to get this set up. And if you guys are willing to go around and do an extra few more steps, I say it's totally definitely worth it. And that's pretty much it. So if you liked this video, I would give it a thumbs up. Please like my videos, okay? I worked really hard on them. That's it for this video. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys on my next one. Peace.